Hello, my dear little ones. Welcome back. I'm so glad that you're here with me today and that you're joining me so that together we can reflect on the readings for this coming Sunday. Before we begin, as we always should begin anything that's important in life, let us make the sign of the holy, precious, and life-giving cross together. Are you ready? Me too. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. My dear little ones, I'm so happy that you're here. And I want to thank Father Joseph for giving us such beautiful reflections these past couple of weeks. Thank you so much, Father Joseph. Now, we have to read from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, because this coming Sunday, we're going to be looking at the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 16, verses 19 through 31. And I have an adapted text here for you. I want you to listen carefully and have no distractions. I want you to listen and be attentive, and I have it in such a way that is going to be easy for you to understand, okay? I have a text here that's been adapted, and so I want you to get really familiar with this parable that our Lord told us, that's recorded for us by the holy apostle and evangelist Saint Luke, so that when you go this Sunday to church, you can listen to your priest, you can listen to your deacon as they read the Holy Gospel, and then you can listen to the homily and be able to connect everything. Okay? Now, listen closely as we reflect on the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee. Jesus told this parable, this story. There was once a very rich man who wore fancy clothes and ate big, delicious meals every single day. Right outside his gate, there was a poor man named Lazarus. Lazarus was so poor and hungry, he wished he could eat even the crumbs that fell from the rich man's table. Lazarus was also very sick, and his skin was covered with sores. The neighborhood dogs would come by and lick his sores because no one else would pay attention to him or care for him. One day Lazarus died, and God's angels took him up to a beautiful and very happy place with Abraham, who was like a loving grandfather. Later, the rich man also died, but he went to a place that was quite different. He went to a place of great sadness and suffering. While at this sad place, the rich man looked up and he saw far away above him that Lazarus, the man who had been poor and sick, was now with Abraham. And he then cried out, "Father Abraham, please have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip his finger in water to give me drink, at least a drop on my tongue, because I am in terrible pain here." But Abraham said, "My child, remember that in your life you had many good things and Lazarus had many bad things. Now he is comforted and you are in pain. Besides, there's a big, deep, open space between us, so no one can cross over." The rich man said, "Then please send Lazarus to my family's house. I have five brothers and I want Lazarus to warn them so they don't make the same mistakes I made and end up in this very sad place." But Abraham replied, "They already have the teachings of Moses and the prophets to guide them. They should listen to them." The rich man said, "But if someone rises from the dead and goes to them, they will listen and turn back to God." Abraham said, "If they won't listen to Moses and the prophets, they will not be convinced, even if someone rises from the dead." Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee. Wow. My dear little ones, did you hear that? Did you hear that? We are reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, and this is the parable of Lazarus and the rich man. The rich man and Lazarus. Now, let's talk about this for just a second. Can we do that? Great. The rich man is not given a name here. We don't know the rich man's name. Wasn't that interesting? Usually, when we're in our society, we know the names of rich people, powerful people, wealthy people, but here, boom, we don't know the name of the rich man. Now, some people say that maybe his name was Dives, D-I-V-E-S, in English, Dives, but in Latin pronounced Divis, Divis. Can you say that with me? Divis, or Divis, depending on the pronunciation that you want to use. Now, this man is given this name sometimes because in Latin, Dives can be understood as wealth, as being rich. But that's not his proper name. We don't know his proper name, but we do know the name of Lazarus, and we know that Lazarus is a Greek form of the Hebrew name Eliezer, or Eleazar, if you speak Spanish, Eleazar, Eliezer, but we know him as Lazarus. That's our Greek tradition. That's how we have Lazarus. In this parable that our Lord tells us, it's quite reversed. We know the name of the poor man, not of the wealthy man. Now, let's talk about riches a little bit. Can we do that? Saint Cyril gives us a clear warning when it comes to this parable, and I want you to listen closely. Saint Cyril says to us, riches are not bad in and of themselves. So if you were wondering, is it bad to be rich? What if when I grow up I'm successful? What if I do have a little bit of resources and money? Is that bad? No. Saint Cyril gives us a clear indication that riches in themselves are not bad. But those who have riches, says Saint Cyril, are to care for others that surround them, especially if they have enough to not only care for themselves, but to care for those that are around them and in need. So that's important. Let's make this clear. Just because one is rich, it doesn't mean that one is automatically bad or in trouble. And just because one is poor, one is not automatically holy and good either. Listen to what Saint Ambrose of Milan tells us. He says, not all poverty is holy or all riches criminal. But as luxury disgraces riches, so does holiness commend poverty. Let me explain that a little bit easier for you to understand. What Saint Ambrose is telling us here is basically this. Being poor isn't always holy, and being rich isn't always bad. What matters is how we use what we have, how we use what we have. If someone is rich and spends a lot of money on too many fancy things for themselves, that can be bad. That can be bad. And if someone is poor and they still, even though they're poor, they love God with all their heart, that can make their life very special and they can end up being super close to God. What's more important, my dear little brothers and sisters, is our inner disposition. What's going on in your heart? What's going on in your mind? And how you are loving those that surround you. Now let's talk about love for just a moment. Let's talk about love. Did you hear in the story how nobody would show Lazarus love? The rich man who had the ability to show love didn't show him any love. Nobody except for who? That's right, the little doggies. There were dogs in that neighborhood. There were street dogs that were coming up and they were showing love to Lazarus. They were licking his wounds. They were sitting there with him, spending some time with him. Those dogs that were from the streets had more manners and more love and more care for Lazarus than this rich man who lived in this fancy, big, beautiful house. Wow, the irony there. Street dogs with more manners than a rich man in a beautiful house. Now, let's talk about this, my dear little ones. As we're reflecting on all this, I want you to know that I want to give you an assignment today. I have an assignment for you. I want you to start thinking about nativity. I want you to start thinking about nativity. My assignment for you, my dear little ones, is I want you to ask yourself, what am I going to do to not be like this rich man? I don't want to be like the rich man, you should say. What am I going to do to not be like this rich man this coming nativity fast, this coming Christmas? What can I do? So, little ones, I want you to bring this up during dinner, okay? During dinner, bring this up to your parents, ask them. Say, what can we do? What can I do? And parents, indeed, please bring this up. What are you going to do as a family? What are you going to do as individuals? That's your assignment. I want you to think about this because nativity is fast approaching and I want you and I want myself to be prepared. So think about that and think about what you can do as individuals and what you can do as a family to not live like the rich man, but to show love, kindness, and care for those that surround us that are in need. May God bless you and keep you all the days of your lives. Thank you so much for joining me. God bless you. I'll see you next time.
Patristic Nectar Publications is blessed to present a new publication never before translated into the English language. Entitled Against All Heresies, with a dialogue against the Latins and chapters on prayer by the great 14th century Archbishop and theologian Saint Simeon of Thessalonica. This profound work offers Christians a compact heresiology and a holistic introduction to the Church's theology, greatly edifying for both clergy and laity, Against All Heresies addresses critical issues of immediate relevance, including the Orthodox Church's relationship to both Islam and Roman Catholicism. This new text is available in two formats, a hardcover edition with the original Greek text, or a paperback edition in English. It's also available on audiobook and ebook. Order your copies today at patristicnectar.org.